Doctor, today I wanted you to explain a little bit the Ayurvedic concept of taste. That is, how much, why all the tastes are needed in every meal, and then for a well-functioning, healthy body.
Coming to the role of taste, Ayurveda explains anybody's diet in the form of balanced diet, in the form of balancing of all these tastes.
Mm.
So, there is no concept of protein, carbohydrate and these things. Instead, they have given us a concept of six basic tastes. They are sweet, astringent, bitter, pungent, salty and sour. Yeah, sweet, sour, salty, bitter, astringent and pungent taste. Sweet, for example, is any of the sweet items. It need not be sugar itself. Honey is sweet, milk is sweet, water is sweet. So the relative sweetness is different, and their effects also on the doshas or the energies will be different based on this. The same principle applies to all the six tastes. So when we talk about a balanced diet, all these six tastes should be there in a diet.
In every meal.
Proportions, every meal. Mm. Yeah, that is what they say. Consumption of a single taste or just two tastes will be imbalanced diet.
Mm.
When you want to balance a diet, it should be all six tastes in combination, but in different proportions. Mm. For example, sweet taste should be dominant. That indicates itself is like the concept of nutrition. When we talk about carbohydrates, will be the major portion of a diet, and carbohydrate represents sweet taste.
So rice, wheat, all come under sweet taste.
All come under sweet.
Mm.
Yeah, even milk, that will be under sweet taste, predominant taste.
Mm.
Every food item will have different combination of taste, not just single taste.
Mm.
But the dominant taste will be considered as its predominant taste.
Mm.
Yeah. So, when we consume a meal, it should have all these tastes in different proportions. Sweet should be the major taste.
Mm.
So, and then bitter and astringent will be in very minimal quantity, which represent all these trace elements.
Mm.
Yeah, nutrients, vitamins and trace elements will be represented by these tastes.
Mm.
And then pungent is all the spices we add, which is like chili or,
pepper.
Cinnamon, pepper and these things, ginger. Mm. They all represent predominantly the pungent taste.
Mm.
They are required for stimulating the digestive system, stimulating the glands, improving the secretions, opening up channels and all that.
Mm.
So, those spices are added to increase these qualities in a food.
Mm.
And salt taste is required to give taste and also to open up channels and create a proper absorption environment for the food and after digestion also.
To make it palatable and...
palatable.
Mm.
And also it has its own physiological functions of opening up the channels and lubricating inside. And you can see salt is so hygroscopic. It can absorb moisture and retain moisture inside.
Mm.
So that is also one of the functions of salt.
Mm.
And salty taste, not just in salt. It can be there in other food part items we eat as well.
Mm.
And then sour. Sour is like acidic taste.
Mm.
So it may be lemon or it may be in tamarind or it may be vinegar.
Mm.
But whatever natural is what is preferred.
Mm.
So that is required to stimulate digestive system, improve secretion of digestive juices again.
Mm.
And also it has vitamin C when we take sour substances. Most of them will have ascorbic acid in it from the natural source. So it supplements vitamin C as well.
Mm.
And then astringent is a taste which creates choking sensation in our throat.
Mm. Some constricting.
Constricting feeling in our throat. So you can observe that taste in like green leafy vegetables, tender leaves, tender mango, tender pomegranate or pomegranate skin.
Mm.
These all will give you that astringent taste.
Mm.
And that is required for healing properties. If there is a wound, then also we recommend to apply an astringent paste or decoction on it to improve this healing.
To seal the whole wound.
So that also represents some of the trace elements which are required for nutrition and supportive system of body and even immune system improvement. And yeah, so this is how we talk about
and the predominant taste of the meal can vary a little bit depending on the season.
That's right. Mm. So if Vata dosha is dominant, then we say sweet taste should be dominant.
Mm.
And if Pitta is more, then again sweet can be there. Sweet is both pacifying to Vata and Pitta.
Mm.
Whereas Kapha will be pacified by bitter and astringent and pungent taste.
Mm.
So each three sets of tastes have effect on each dosha, either aggravating or pacifying. That kind of nature is there for all the six tastes. So balancing of these is important and critical in maintaining our health in our diet.
Mm.
Thank you.